A new approach to online travels. Let's talk about it with Diego Furlani, CEO of Salaban and Bado Bay. But before that, don't forget to subscribe our channel. Hi Diego, how are you doing today?
Hi Matteo, thank you for this opportunity to talk with you. I'm fine, thanks. You?
Fine, thanks for being with us. So let's start immediately. You launched two startups, one called Salaban and one called Bado Bay. What are they about and what's the difference between them?
Okay, Salaban and Bado Bay are the main two brands of our company that are travel solutions for B2B needs. We develop solutions that our customers use for promotion, contest, loyalty, incentive, and welfare plans. Basically, Salaban is an evolution of the traditional gift box. It's a voucher where you can book over 500,000 different properties all around the world. Every availability is in real time, and you have also the instant confirmation of your reservation. We mix the traditional gift box system with the modern method of booking an hotel. The end user enters in our platform with this code. He sets the destination, the check-in date, and the number of participants. In few minutes, he can see, in few seconds, really, he can see all the availabilities we have with his box and can book the solution he prefers. At the same time, I receive the confirmation by email. Salaban is used in particular as a prize in contest or promotion and welfare plans. Bado Bay instead is a travel booking system where you can book in real time between a lot of hotels, B&Bs and apartments. It's a sort of booking.com for B2B needs. How it works, through a gift card or through one of our partners that are integrated with us with a single sign-on integration, you can enter our platform, by the way. It's not open to the public. You set the destination, the check-in and the check-out date, and the number of participants. In few seconds, you can see all the availabilities we have in the destination without any other condition, and you can choose between the one you prefer. In few seconds, you receive by email the confirmation of your reservation. Our added value is a mix of technology and human touch. We improve our product every day in order to offer the best solution to our customers and how they approach to our services. On the other side, we have put a point on a customer service that is a multi-channel service. Our customer can have answers by email, by the phone, by a live chat or by WhatsApp. Technology and customer service work together as we develop some solutions in answer to issues referred by our customer service.
The question that I have for you is why two platforms? Because they look pretty similar to me, but they are two different brands. So what's the reason why you decided to keep them separated?
That's a big question, and we thought a lot about that before launched the new service Bado Bay last February as a brand new. Salaban has been launched 5 years ago. We decided to have two different brands to avoid any confusion for the final user about the functionality and the different use of the two products. This is the main reason we thought, but we have also considered other advantages and other consideration. On the commercial side, we can differentiate in an easier way the condition we put in place with our client with two brands. On the fiscal rules, we have different rule we have to follow, so it would be easy to have two different brands to manage this side. And lastly, but really important, on the, we have marketing advantages to have two different brands. As we sell our product on online distributors, so having two brands, we have more spaces on their digital shelves.
So for end users, The booking system for trips, for hotels, for flights, even, which is not your case, but anyway, it's a similar type of market. It's very open nowadays, thanks to internet. You just go on the website of a hotel and you make a reservation over there. You have this challenge, in my opinion, in your business. How do you face it?
Oh yes, travel market is a really mature digital market. Every day we compete with hotels, travel agencies, OTAs as Booking or Expedia every day. So the only way you can compete, and I mean not only in our market but in every market, is to offer an added value to your customers and how they reach you. Hotels, for example, with their direct booking systems, are not for us a direct customer, a competitor. Even if we are serving the same need, that to have a bed where to sleep the night. Because the customer journey of our client is slightly different from the one that an hotel has. So what we do is to understand what our customer needs and how they approach to our services. And in order to offer a recognizable added value, we put two important points on technology and customer service. On the technology side, it's important for us to offer a simple and safe platform to our clients, so they would have a good customer experience. On the other hand, we think really crucial to in these times to have a customer care ready to answer the question your customer have. Prices, a wide range of different properties, and the direct integration to our clients are other important points that we have set that allow us to compete in such a competitive market.
And what are the challenges, the main challenges, or the main challenge that you faced when you decided to launch your business online?
I think the main challenge when you start a company is to find a new customer. Let me say, I'm really surprised when I stand at a startup event or I read on specific media that how to find a new customer is never a topic on the startup ecosystem. You haven't a brand, and it's so common when you start a new business not to have a brand. You have a product that is slightly different from the product that are in the market. When we started with Salabam, for instance, we were proposing a gift box without the box, only digital, with a dynamic list of hotels you can book, instead a fixed list. When we started, me and Marco, that is one of my co-founders, we made a lot of talks to find new customers. When you finally find a new customer, it's important for you to recognize a pattern so you can replicate your sales model and scale it. And for us, it happened. So we find some channels for our product and we follow this street.
I see. And talking about challenges, we are doing this interview in the middle of October 2020, and we are almost in the middle of the second wave of COVID. How was your business affected, and how did you react to this situation?
Oh, first of all, Matteo, I hope for those who are suffering now about this virus would be negative as soon as possible and without any consequences. COVID has had and is still having a great impact on our business sector. What we have done and what we are doing now is to try to put ourselves in the shoes of our customers and try to do what they would expect to receive. We had to deal with the pandemic even in January, before the lockdown in Italy, since we have some reservations in China and Southeast Asia. We have done lots of things during this month due to the pandemic, and as the wave of infection has moved. For instances, in spring, we canceled all the reservations we have We preferred to block for a period, the lockdown period, the possibility to book. And in summer, we have extended the duration of our vouchers, I mean, for Salabam, for our new customers. And we have set during the booking process all the information we have about the cleaning and safety practices we made by the properties to give more information to our customers. As the pandemic is coming back in our area, we would be ready to set actions the situation requires. But at the same time, we have made a lot of things internally. I mean, we have used this time to improve our technologies in our products. We are launching in these weeks the new Salaban site. Now we are testing it with a group of customers. And we have solved some bugs we have on the customer journey on Evaluate. At the end, we have tried to keep a good mood inside the company, especially with the young people. So we use the time to train a lot. We have seen a lot of webinars, especially for the youngest people that, some of them were entering in the company. So they were the people we have to care more.
One last question. Italians is about also helping startups or small businesses like yours to obtain visibility abroad. So I want you to give you 1 minute in order for you to pitch your company and eventually find, I don't know, whatever you're looking for, either customers or partners out of Italy.
Basically, one of the most important things I've learned these years is to keep on sharing talks and time with different people. You learn a lot when you speak with someone new, and maybe you find some ideas you wouldn't have. So, answering your question, we are open to have meet or just talk with customer partners and personal, all of them. Customers are always important. If important for you to grow, and with customers you can grow in an easy way, and it's important for you to keep the ones you have already. Working in a digital way, we don't have a stock-related issue, so every new customer is important for us. Important, as I mentioned before, is to find a pattern about your new customers so you can replicate your sales model and scale it. About new partners, to find new partners is also important, of course. As you can develop your product, maybe you can offer new services or add a new function to your product that would be important for your customers. And speaking with different managers or entrepreneurs, you could also find new solutions, new ideas, or maybe see a new need you could solve and open a new business unit. About personnel, they are important as well. Probably they are the crucial part of the company, and it's so important to have a talented group of people. About that, I'm reading the book written by Reed Hastings, the CEO of Netflix, and he suggested in his book that the main reason they are growing so fast during these years is their team. With this team and how he managed them, Netflix was able to find new solutions for their customer, pivoting their model at least 3 or 4 times, and becoming the company everyone knows now. So, to find new personnel for us, new talented people, is important too.
Diego, thank you so much for your time today, and let me wrap up what you just said. Today, thanks to Diego, we learned that number one is technology that should adapt to consumers and not the other way around. Number two, human touch can make the difference, especially in customer service. Number three, verticals are super important to make sure that you make business in a sustainable way. Become an expert in one sector, and you will see that you will have many more opportunities. Alright, if you enjoyed this video, please hit the like button down here and subscribe our channel to watch more videos like this.
Thanks to the Danubius Hotel in Regent Park, London for hosting us and see you soon on Italians. Cheers and ciao!